These next few modules will introduce you to current CSULB freshmen and transfer students who have connected in one way or another to various resources and programs on campus. Listen as they share their experiences and suggestions to first-year students and their parents and family members. First, we invite you to listen to a short clip taken from an interview with two STEM freshman students. Deisy and Sai will share the benefits of connecting to the campus by becoming involved in campus clubs and organizations and by engaging in undergraduate research. You will hear references to the Undergraduate Research Opportunity Program, or UROP, a one-year program that offers first and second-year students the chance to participate in the research and creative process with faculty. The full-length video link can be found in the description box below.
So this question you have kind of answered for me, Zai, in one aspect, because you did UROP, right, and you talked about that process. But did you, either of you, become involved in campus organizations and or events? If so, what were those? And if not, why not did you attend? So Deisy, we can start with you because I know that you have joined some student organizations. So I want you to talk to us about that.
So yes, I got involved just because I wanted to have like a sense of community, and because you also get to meet upperclassmen and they can give you like recommendations, whether on professors, classes, and yeah. So I joined two clubs that focus more on like Hispanic Latinos going into STEM. I really wanted that community because I know not that many Hispanics or Latinos go into STEM. So they were MAES, which is like Mexican Americans in Science and Scientists. And then the other one is SHIP, which is like specifically like, they both serve the same purpose, which is for Hispanics. And then I also participated in Societies of Women Engineers. And I also did Beach Team, which is something not related to STEM, so yeah.
Okay, great, thank you. And how about you, Zai? Did you join any clubs or student organizations?
I looked into clubs and student organizations, but I personally got scared. Like I felt like I would have been overwhelmed with my course load and being in Europe. So I did try and look into them and I went for meetings, but I ultimately decided that I think I need more time to properly join campus organizations.
Yes, and that's okay, because I think one of the things that we talked about, at least in my memory, in Step into STEM was to make sure that we are balancing and then we're prioritizing that. Because we don't do one semester doesn't mean we can't do it again. So you can always join clubs in your sophomore, junior year, maybe your second semester of freshman year. And then Deisy, I know that you were very active, right, in the student organizations. What did you learn from your student org work? And then Zai, your question will be, what have you learned from research? So I really want to know, what are some of the things you've learned in research this semester? You can kick us off if you'd like.
Referring to
To research, you know, walk us through what you're doing, your processes and the things that you're learning. And, you know, are you involved in any papers, things like that?
So being involved in research helped me learn how to manage, I learned how to manage my time more. And also I learned how to communicate to faculty more. I felt like in high school, we were expected to do everything alone. And while yes, because we're online, it's kind of a self-paced situation. I also learned that you don't, you're not alone. You can reach out for help. You're not expected to suffer, you know? You're expected to do your best by reaching out. Yeah.
Thank you. All right, Deisy, what did you learn from the student orgs?
What I learned was one, to like, don't hesitate to reach out. Like everyone's like also willing to help you. And also with time management, like what Sai said, like it really does help you kind of improve on your time management, see what you prioritize. And also the clubs also emphasize on like your soft skills, which is like your communications and also like your leadership. So yeah.
Great.
Next, you will hear Jessanne, Jose, Nicole, and Sam, CSULB transfer students, share what motivates them to be successful STEM college students. In this clip, you will learn about HSI STEM's Summer Bridge to the Beach research program, as well as the STEM, Excel, College of Engineering, and College of Natural Sciences and Mathematics peer mentor program. The full-length video can be found in the description box below.
Now to all of you. What motivates you to be a successful college student, regardless of remote or in-person learning?
I can start that one. I love the material that makes up my degree. I mean, we have to take this course called soil mechanics. It's dirt physics. And to me, it's so interesting. And I find the graphs in these books so beautiful and the teaching so like interesting and applicable to other courses. So that motivates me, you know, to do well, I guess. Yeah. Besides that, I want a good life after college. I want to set myself up for success. So, you know, even if it means working a little harder right now, I'm okay with that, because in the long run, that really helps me. And it did, you know, I invested a ton of time into professional development and getting good grades and pursuing extracurricular activities, and that helped me get a job. And I feel really great right now.
So for me, I've always enjoyed the sciences for, since I was young. And also like Sam said, I really enjoy what I'm studying, and I've really grown a love for biochemistry and enzymes. And I just really enjoy it. So that's like a plus. But on top of that, you know, being a woman of color and like Latina is really challenging in STEM. And I just feel really proud of where I am, and to see that, you know, I'm going to be added to the next like generation of women that are in STEM, that are Latina, that can do it and that did do it. And I think that's important, and that's something that I'm really proud of and excited to just get my degree. And yeah, so that motivates me.
Yeah, I definitely resonate with what Sam and Nicole said. Just when you know you love what you study, it just kind of gives you that extra incentive to dive deeper into what you want to do. And especially when you know what options there are for you, you want to like make sure you hone in and kind of keep that passion and that drive. And similar to Nicole, I am about to be the first engineer in my family, and I'm a first generation daughter of Filipino immigrants that came to the U.S. So it's just one of those things where I want to kind of pave the way for other women, especially who grew up in areas where they don't think that getting a career in engineering is possible. And I just want to like make sure that I do my best so that I could bring others along with me. And yeah, that definitely keeps me going, especially right now during the pandemic.
What sometimes motivates me is kind of questioning my why. And that usually has to do with like, well, why am I in college in the first place? And so far, like being in the biology major, the one thing that I've kind of like looked at in terms of like where I want to go is conservation biology. And that's one field where I felt that some people weren't paying enough attention to. And overall, I just feel privileged to, you know, live where I am, living the life that I am, and having the privilege to study what I'm studying, and also being able to later contribute to that in life.
Jose, as a peer mentor, what are your suggestions for first year students who are finding that they really aren't motivated by their major, and they might be thinking there's something else, another major, another field of study that would be better for them?
I can answer. I think it's really important to like be honest with yourself first. And once you know that, you could have a conversation with someone you trust, whether it be a professor you gain a relationship with, or a parent or a sibling or aunt and uncle, and just kind of talk it out and say like, hey, I don't think this is the right path for me. I think I want to do this. And then maybe they could kind of either encourage you to go see what's out there, like what resources that they have at Cal State Long Beach. Because I'm sure there's, with whatever like path you want to take, there's someone at the college who could help you get on the right path. So my advice would just to be follow your gut too. And don't let any more like time pass by, because you want to just kind of get, make sure you're on the right track, even if it's not 100% like what you want to do, as long as it's going towards that. I think it's definitely important to explore that.
In terms of addressing self-doubt, in terms of like, oh, is this path the correct path? Sometimes we like to think of progress and our everything to be like just super smooth, super like linear, when in reality it has a bunch of twists and turns, and that's actually normal. If you have doubts about a major, if you have like, oh, what if I could do this? What if I can do that? Just remember that CSULB has plenty of resources. They have advisors. You have friends. You can have friends to talk that over with. And really, I'm a firm believer in that there's plenty of opportunity out there. And sometimes it's like, maybe you want to go this direction, but then if something's calling you somewhere else, go ahead, take that leap.
I'd also like to add on to this a couple points. One, some majors, they don't really lock you into a job. You know, some majors, you know, if you study that major, you actually have options to pursue like 100 different jobs, you know, across maybe several fields. The other thing that helped me is to pursue resources outside of school, like professional societies or just, you know, regional organizations. You know, if you want to be an engineer or like a civil engineer, you should try to get involved with those organizations and get a firsthand experience, or, you know, get some questions answered about what it's actually like be a civil engineer. And I'm sure there's similar organizations out there for the other colleges as well.
Thank you.
Listen to the introduction of Nicole and Sam's presentations about the research they have been conducting within the CNSM and COE research labs during these past 2 years. The full-length video to each presentation can be found in the description box below.
Hello, everyone. My name is Nicole Paz Bracamonte, and I am in Dr. Jason Schwantz's lab at Cal State Long Beach. My research is titled Incorporating Substrate Features in FMOC Amino Acids to Develop More Potent and Specific Butyrylcholinesterase Inhibitors for the Potential Treatment of Alzheimer's Disease.
Hi, everyone. My name is Samuel Dominguez. I am a former Summer Bridge to the Beach research scholar, also a former transfer student. And today I want to briefly talk to you about two research projects that I did upon transferring to Cal State Long Beach about 1 and 2 years ago. So the first research project I did was called Analyzing Heavy Civil Construction Equipment Emission Factors in Terms of Feasibility. This project was done through HSI STEM, through a program called the Summer Bridge to the Beach Research Scholar Program. Basically, just in the summer before I transferred to Cal State Long Beach, I got paired up with faculty in the department I was transferring to. And whatever research they were doing, I was allowed to help them. So I got paired up with Dr. Kim, who's a professor of construction management. This is like the sister program of what I'm studying, civil engineering. And we did this project.